Hey everyone, I'm Anupam Vij from Azure Core, and today we're going to talk about how you can protect your infrastructure in Azure against DDoS attacks. We're going to learn about the DDoS attack trends, but then there are new features that we want to introduce and hope you're going to enjoy. So before we talk about how Azure DDoS Protection Standard can help you mitigate the DDoS attacks against your application, let's review some of the 2021 DDoS attack trends that we have seen. With COVID situation, in 2021, the first half, we have seen that the frequency of the DDoS attacks have increased by 25%. It's not only the frequency of the DDoS attacks that are increasing, but it's also the volume of DDoS attacks that continues to grow year over year. Just this week, we released a blog post that Azure mitigated 2.4 terabytes of DDoS attack, which is the second largest DDoS attack ever known. One of the reasons is also because it's extremely easy to generate these attacks these days through pay-for-hire services. With the simplicity of generation of these DDoS attacks, but the complexity involved to mitigate these multi-vector attacks, it's imperative that you are protecting your infrastructure and critical applications in Azure with the right protections in place. Also knowing that 87% of the DDoS attacks are under an hour, any resource with a public IP that is receiving traffic from the internet is susceptible to DDoS attacks. It's not a question of if you would be attacked, but it's rather a question of when you can be attacked. With that, let's do a recap of what Azure DDoS Protection Standard service is and how it can help you protect your critical applications against the DDoS attacks. Azure DDoS Protection Standard offers the cloud-scale DDoS protection for your workloads and virtual networks in Azure. It's integrated with Azure Global Networking, which means that we leverage the scale of 62 Azure regions and 50 terabits of mitigation capacity to mitigate the largest DDoS attacks known to the mankind. It also ensures that we can mitigate multiple DDoS attacks of significant volume all at the same time as well, ensuring that your application's availability and performance is not impacted. The way we do that is through adaptive tuning. The adaptive tuning ensures that the DDoS protection policies that are being set are specific to your application's workload and the scale of your application. And when or if your application is under DDoS attack, we will automatically start doing the mitigation. And as we are doing the attack mitigation, you will have full capability to review the actions that we are taking by analyzing the attack analytics as well as the telemetry. We integrate the attack analytics and the telemetry with Azure Security Center, as well as Azure Sentinel, if you use Azure Sentinel as your SIEM system in Azure. We also allow you to integrate the attack analytics and the telemetry with your offline SIEM systems like Splunk, with the idea that all the data is out there for you, not only for compliance, not only for transparency, but the data is actionable, where you can do the correlation analysis and ensure that other than the DDoS attacks, your environment is secure and no other malicious activity is happening in your environment. With DDoS Protection Standard, we also offer DDoS Rapid Response. Majority of the times, when there is a DDoS attack that happens on the application, you don't have to reach out to us, but we do understand that there are instances where you may want to reach out to our team, and that's where the DDoS Rapid Response helps. If you engage the DDoS Rapid Response within less than 15 minutes or less, our engineering team will work with you to put custom mitigation policies in place as needed to ensure, again, that your application's availability and performance is not impacted during the time of DDoS attack. We also ensure that we offer you or provide you with more detailed information or forensic information post the attack such that you can use it for compliance or auditing or reporting. We offer 99.99% SLA guarantee such that if your application is under DDoS attack, we guarantee that your application's availability and performance won't be impacted. But we also offer cost protection. Cost protection ensures that during the time of DDoS attack, if you incur the cost of scale out of your resources, then you get the 100% cost credit back. The example of the scale-out resources is, for instance, if you have set your virtual machines to auto-scale, and the virtual machine scales from 10 VMs to 100 VMs, you don't have to worry about paying the cost of those 90 scaled-out VMs. The same is also applicable whether you are deploying Azure Firewall, you are deploying Application Gateway, or even more importantly, if you incur the cost of the bandwidth, which is particularly more rampant if you undergo a DDoS attack, which is an amplification attack. In those instances, your applications will start making significant outbound connections where you can incur a significant bandwidth charge. By using DDoS Protection Standard, you will get the cost credit back for the duration of the DDoS attacks. Adaptive tuning. In DDoS protection, there are two components. There is a detection, and then there is a mitigation. Adaptive tuning applies to the detection component. When you onboard to DDoS Protection Standard, which is done by enabling it on a virtual network, automatically in the backend, we identify all the public IPs that are inside the virtual network. And for each public IP, we define three DDoS detection policies. The one policy is for TCP SYN, the other is for TCP, and the third policy is for UDP protocol. One of the key attributes in each of these policies is at what point do we think there's a DDoS attack happening on your application? And the way we determine that is through our proprietary machine learning algorithm, which understands the scale of your application, that is the number of virtual machines behind the public IP, but also understands the traffic profile that's incoming to the application. So on a regular basis, if your application receives 40,000 packets per second, and then there is a seasonality associated with it, our machine learning algorithm will learn that, and it will understand that. And then based on that, we define those policy thresholds to initiate DDoS mitigation. This way, we ensure that the mitigation is initiated automatically when there is an anomaly in the traffic pattern, as well as we think that the amount of traffic that's incoming to your application can cause your application to go down. With attack analytics and Sentinel integration, we ensure that you get access to near real-time information about the actions that we are taking as we are doing the attack mitigation against your environment. You get to understand what are the top sources that are participating in the DDoS attack, what are the top countries and the AS numbers from where the attacks is originating, as well as the attack vectors that are in play. We also highlight the IPs and the ports that are being attacked in your environment with the intent that all of this information is actionable, that you can take action on, as well as you can use it for compliance and security audit. We are happy to announce that DDoS integration with the Firewall Manager is available as public preview. So if you're using Azure Firewall Manager, you now have one place to go from where you can onboard to DDoS Protection Standard for your entire tenant. All you need to do is navigate to the virtual network subsection of the Azure Firewall Manager, and there you would be able to view the virtual networks that are protected with DDoS Protection Standard, as well as the virtual networks that are not protected. Using a single pane of glass, now you have the capability to ensure that both the firewall as well as the DDoS Protection Standard compliance is reflected. And then if you're not 100% compliant, then using the same single pane of glass, Azure Firewall Manager, you can onboard your virtual network right there itself. We are also happy to announce that inline DDoS protection with Gateway LB integration is now available through the partner NVAs, through our marketplace ecosystem. Azure DDoS Protection Standard is always on and protects against the layer 3 and layer 4 attacks, but it's not inline. Inline means that the traffic is always going through the DDoS mitigation pipeline, whereas the DDoS Protection Standard takes anywhere from 30 to 60 seconds to detect an attack. And when an attack is detected, we put the traffic through the DDoS mitigation pipeline. Now, why is inline DDoS mitigation important? For the latency-sensitive applications that cannot tolerate the 30 seconds of warm-up period for the DDoS mitigation to kick in, it's imperative to always have the traffic going through the DDoS mitigation pipeline. And that is what now the partners in Azure can offer through their NVA and the ecosystem. Let me explain to you what this diagram is capturing here and how you can ensure that your latency-sensitive applications can be further secured using this solution. In this scenario, we are taking an example of the game servers because the gaming workloads are highly latency-sensitive and they're also susceptible to DDoS attacks. Starting with bullet point one over here, the traffic from the internet, which we call as the unfiltered traffic, comes to the load balancer IP behind which the game servers are deployed. The load balancer IP on which the traffic from the internet is coming to is the public IP of that load balancer. Now, once the traffic comes to the load balancer IP, it's automatically redirected to the private IP of the gateway load balancer. Behind that gateway load balancer is where the partner NVAs that can do the inline DDoS mitigation are connected to. Now, once the traffic goes to the gateway load balancer, it will go through the partner NVAs, which will do the DDoS mitigation and inspection. And then the clean traffic or the filtered traffic would be sent back to the public IP of the load balancer of the game servers. This ensures that the NVAs inspects all the supposed malicious traffic and only pass the supposed clean traffic back to the game servers, again, thereby ensuring that the game servers are not impacted due to lower volume, layer 7 or application layer DDoS attacks. Now, the game server behind the public IP of the load balancer is also susceptible to layer 3, layer 4 DDoS attacks. And that's where the recommendation is to also enable DDoS protection standard on the virtual network of the game server's load balancer. This way, you get layer 3 to layer 7 comprehensive protection against DDoS attacks. This scenario is not only limited to game servers, but will also cater towards other workloads which are latency sensitive, including the web workloads. All right, so let's take a look at DDoS protection standard in action. I'll give you a demo on how to onboard to DDoS protection standard and some of the key features that we also talked about today. So in order to onboard to DDoS protection standard, you need to create a DDoS protection plan. So if you search for DDoS in the marketplace, then the top service that shows up, just click on the DDoS protection plans and then create a DDoS protection plan. And what you will see is it's asking for subscription information. And that's really the key, because once you link it to the subscription, you cannot move the plan to another subscription. But just because you have linked the DDoS protection plan to a subscription, it still means that you can use the same plan for all other subscriptions in the same tenant. So the plan is linked to a subscription, but it applies for all the subscriptions in a given tenant. So select the subscription, provide it a resource group, give it a name, and then hit review and create. So I already have the DDoS plan created in the subscription. Now, once you have created the plan, what you need to do is you need to navigate to the virtual network and navigate to the DDoS protection sublayer. By default, it's set to disable. All you need to do to onboard to DDoS protection standard is click on enable, link it to the plan that you have created, and hit save. When you do that, automatically in the backend, we will identify all the public IPs that are associated in that virtual network. And then for each public IP, we're going to define DDoS mitigation policies. So let's take a look at some of the DDoS mitigation policies that we defined and how it looks through Azure Monitor. So I'm going back here and I will go back to the Azure Monitor. And we are going to take a look at the DDoS policies that we have defined for one of the public IPs. So here in the scope, I'm going to select public IP as a scope. And remember, even though DDoS protection standard is enabled on a virtual network, the protection applies on the public IP. So let me find out a public IP here, and I'll just select this public IP. Now, under the metrics, you'll see a bunch of metrics out here, and these are all related to DDoS protection standard. Most of the metrics will not be populated unless we are doing the mitigation, but the policy threshold metrics will be populated. So as I mentioned, for each public IP, we define three policy settings: SIM, packets to trigger DDoS mitigation, TCP packets to trigger DDoS mitigation, and UDP packets. So if we take a look at the SYN packets, we'll see that the policy threshold that we have defined here is 100,000 packets per second based on the amount of traffic this IP is receiving as well as the number of virtual machines behind this IP. Likewise, if we take a look at the TCP packets to trigger DDoS mitigation, we'll find that it's set at 2 million packets. Now, what it means is that once the traffic volume goes above 2 million packets per second is when we will detect as an anomaly and we will initiate DDoS mitigation. Now, when we initiate DDoS mitigation, the other metrics will start getting populated in Azure Monitor, where you can see the number of packets that are incoming to the IP, the number of packets that we are dropping because we deem those as malicious, as well as the number of packets that we are forwarding. So this is Azure Monitor. The other interesting thing to note is to onboard, if you have onboarded to the diagnostic settings for the DDoS logs, then you would be able to also see the attack analytics associated with DDoS logs. So here, let me open the other browser here. And so I have created the log analytic workspace where I have configured that anytime there is a DDoS attack that happens, then the mitigation log should be pumped to this workspace. And this is where you will see the summary of the traffic overview, which again means like, you know, what traffic are we dropping? What traffic are we forwarding? What resources goes under DDoS attack that we are mitigating, as well as like deep information with respect to the attack vectors and the countries and the origins from where the attack is originated. Now, the other thing I'd like to highlight is the firewall manager integration that we have done. The first page shows you how many virtual networks in your environment. If your filter is set to the subscription, then it's showing you how many virtual networks in a given subscription are protected versus the virtual networks that are not protected. But again, as the DDoS plan works cross subscription in a given tenant, so does the firewall manager. So if you remove the subscription filter over here, you will get to see the number of virtual networks that are protected with DDoS Protection Standard across multiple subscriptions in the same tenant. If you navigate to the virtual networks here, then you would be able to see how many VNets are protected with DDoS Protection Standard, and then the virtual networks that are not protected with DDoS Protection Standard. So here what you can see are the virtual networks where you have configured DDoS Protection Plan and you are protecting it with DDoS Protection Standard. Now, for the virtual networks which are not linked to a DDoS protection plan, it means that it's not getting the standard protection. In order to onboard those virtual networks to the DDoS protection standard, all you need to do is to click here on the virtual network and then select Manage Security, select Manage DDoS Protection, enable, and link it to the plan that you have created in your environment and hit Save. With Firewall Manager, now you have one place where you can configure not only your firewall settings, but as well as DDoS protection standard settings for your entire tenant. Thanks a lot, everyone, for attending the session. Hope this session was informational. The key takeaway is that public IPs receiving traffic over the internet are susceptible to DDoS attacks. Do make sure that your infrastructure is protected against DDoS attacks and your applications are highly available. Do review the links in this deck, and thanks a lot again.